Hi friends, welcome to my channel. And in this video, we are going to do a mock exam for AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner exam. So this is a prep or a practice exam wherein we will follow the same exam pattern, and then we would go through the question and answer. At the end, there would be a result as well. So before we begin, AWS Cloud Practitioner is the foundation exam for starting your cloud journey, or for learning any of the cloud certification. This is optional, this is not compulsory, but once you do this foundation, you could do all the other certifications. It gives you very good prospect for the job, also for the promotion, and also if you want to prove yourself certified there and you're working, it is also helpful. So focusing on AWS Cloud Practitioner certification exam, this is the syllabus which is on my screen. And these are the rules. Basically, you will get 65 questions and 90 minutes to solve them. Passing marks are 70%. And this is mainly concept, like you would not see any code, or this is typically non-technical. So the person who is in business, or a person who is non-technical, can also do that. For technical, there are different exams like the developers or solution architect and things like that. So it's going to be easy. It has multiple choice question and answers. So without any delay, let's start with the exam. This is our first question. Before we do that, please like the video and subscribe the channel and spread the word. So let's begin. Question one, which one of the following will impact the price paid for an EC2 instance? You have to select two. So if your instance type is bigger, it would cost you more. The availability zone where the instance is provisioned. These are the two factors which would impact the price. Some of the availability zone, sometime it's cheaper. And number of private IPs, I'm not sure about this, but we can mark it for the review. And we'll see it at the end, what's the correct answer. You can leave in the YouTube video comments if you think what is the correct answer according to for question one. Question two, an organization runs many systems and uses many AWS products. Which of the following service enable them to control how each developer interact with these products? So when you talk about any user, the obvious answer would be identity and access management. So that each developer would have particular roles based on which they can access different products, role-based access. Which AWS service can be used to store and reliably deliver message across distributed system? It is simple queuing system, wherein it is PubSub model, publisher subscriber. So one person would publish the message in the queue, and the listener or the subscriber of that topic will get the message, and it can process after that, decoupling of the system based on the message base. Which statement best describe the operational excellence pillar of AWS well-architected framework? The ability to monitor system and improve supporting processes and procedures, the efficient use of computing resource to meet requirements, the ability of a system to recover gracefully from failure, the ability to manage data center operations more efficiently. So operational excellence means the application is fault tolerant, and it is up most of the time, it's highly available. So the ability of a system to recover gracefully from failure would be operational excellence. The ability to monitor system and improve supporting processes and procedures. This also seems like operational excellence means how it is improving. So let's go with one and mark it as review. Where can you store files in AWS? Select two. So you can store files in EFS, which is Elastic File System, and EBS, which is Elastic Block Storage. ECS is Elastic Container Service, which we don't need. SNS is a notification service, and EMR is Elastic MapReduce. Which of the following services allow you to run containerized application on a cluster of EC2 instance? It would be ECS, which is Elastic Container Service. So what would ECS do is you would register the ECS container images and then based on those registered images, ECS would spin up a EC2 or it would spin up the Fargate, like the serverless version to deploy a containerized application in there. Which statement is correct with regards to AWS service limits? There are no service limits in AWS. You can contact AWS support to increase the service limit. You can use AWS Trusted Advisory to monitor your service limits. Each IAM user has the same service limit. The Amazon Simple Email Service is responsible for sending email notification when usage approach a service limit. Yeah, you can use Trusted Advisor to monitor your service limit. I'm not sure about this. Each IAM user has the same service limits. I think this can happen. I'm not really sure because service limit is for the service, but some user can access more or not. I'm not sure. So I'll go with this and probably this as well. So let's pick this. We will see at the end what happens. Trusted Advisory can monitor our service limits. Which of the following AWS services can be used as a compute resource? EC2 and Lambda. Compute means where you're processing some kind of data. VPC is virtual private cloud. CloudWatch is monitoring, S3 storage. So these are the two which do the computation. What is AWS serverless service that allow you to run your application without any administrative burden? Which would be Lambda is AWS, which means, Lambda is serverless, which means you do not have the burden to manage the servers. It would be done. It would be taken care by AWS. Jessica is managing an e-commerce web application in AWS. The application is hosted on 6 EC2 instances. One day, 3 of the instances crashed, but none of her customer were affected. What has Jessica done correctly in this scenario? She has proper built-in Elastic system. She has properly built-in encrypted system. She has properly built a scalable system. She has properly built a fault-tolerant system. So I could say that there was a fault in 3 of the EC2 instances. So her system was fault tolerant. So the cascading effect did not took the application down. So it was a good fault tolerant system. It could also be built an Elastic system. Elastic system shrinks down and increases basically as with a load. So this is not the case here. Properly built-in encrypted system is related to security, not the case. Properly built a scalable system. So scalable system and Elastic are same. So we'll go with the fault tolerant system. Which of the following aspect of security are managed by AWS? Select two. So hardware patching, encryption of EBS volumes, access permission, securing global physical infrastructure. So AWS would take care of physical infrastructure and hardware patching. Access permission, you can decide. Encryption, you can pick opt-in, opt-out, or you could provide your own keys. And VPC security is again your responsibility. Like the you mean and customer responsibility. A company has created a solution that helps AWS customer improve their architecture on AWS. Which AWS program may support this company? APN consulting partner, AWS TM is technical account manager for the enterprise level. AWS professional services, AWS technology partners. So what this guy is trying to do, a company has created a solution that helps AWS customer improve their architecture. So these solutions are consulting partners who would provide them the suggestions on architecture. Technology partners might build the product for the customers on behalf of AWS, and they have more things to do. AWS professional services are given by AWS itself, and TAM is technical account manager. Which of the following is one of the benefit of moving infrastructure from an on-premise data center to AWS? It would be reduced capital expenditure. So capital gain, capital loss, if you might have heard, is you own something, you invest in something, and then over the period of time, it depreciates. So you have to buy the servers when you have your own data center. But when you go to AWS, you don't buy, you rent. So since that thing comes as a service to you, it is a operational expenses. Till the time you operate it, you have to pay the expenses. The moment you stop operating, there will be no expenses. So that is where the CapEx and OpEx come into picture. Which of the following activities may help reduce your AWS monthly cost? Using the AWS network balancer. To load balancer, not a good idea. Enabling EC2 auto scaling for all your workloads, deploying AWS resource across multiple regions, removing all of your cost association tax. So when you have auto scaling, when workload is less, it will scale down, and then it would help you to reduce the bills or the cost. What are the change management tools that help AWS customer audit and monitor all resource change in their AWS environment? As soon as audit word comes, I would always pick CloudTrail, and then there could be AWS config also, because that way you will get to know if there is some configuration which has been changed. X-ray is usually used for debugging. Transit gateway and Comprehend, I'm not sure about these services. So we'll go with these two, and at the end we'll review it. Which of the following describes the payment model that AWS makes available for customer that can commit to using EC2 for 3-period term to reduce total computing cost? Say when you reserve. So these pay as you go is one model. Pay less as AWS grows. I don't think there is something like that. Pay less by using more. this is called as volume discount, volume usage discount. Save when you reserve. Under the shared responsibility model, which of the following controls do customers fully inherit from AWS? Patching, management control, database control, environmental control, awareness and training, physical control. Environmental controls would be what? So it depends on service. EC2 boxes you have to patch, but other, because it's the guest OS, but other you might not need to patch. So patch management control we can pick, but I'm not sure. So physical control and environmental control we could pick. By the way, I did the mock exam first. You can find it in the list, playlist described in the comments. That was easy. This exam, mock exam 2, is a little bit hard actually. But I am sure we'll pass it if we get 100%. So we are doing it collaboratively. You also try to answer. And then if you are not able to understand any question, you can leave it in the comment in this video. Which of the following AWS offering is a MySQL compatible relational database service that can scale capability automatically based on demand? So there are two actually, Amazon Aurora with MySQL, it is serverless. So it would scale automatically with the demand. And I believe RDS for, this would be Aurora actually. Because I thought this is MySQL, but it is SQL Server. An organization needs to analyze and process a large number of data sets, which service they would use. MapReduce. Wait, it could be MQ. I'm not sure what is MQ, but analyze and process large number of data sets. It could be Elastic MapReduce. Which of the following can help protect your EC2 instances from DDoS? Select two. One you can, I am not sure if security group, but a network access control list, you can deny specific IPs so that it cannot get into the EC2. And then in security group also, you should remove the IP address for the bad actors, so they cannot access your EC2. How are AWS customers built for Linux-based Amazon EC2 usage? EC2 instance will be built on 1 hour increments, built on 1 day increments, on 1 second increment, will be built on 1 minute increment with a minimum of 1 hour. I don't think this is 1 hour. EC2 instance will be built on 1 second increment with a minimum of 1 minute. Probably this would be the proper way because, let's see. Market for review. What are the default security credentials that are required to access the AWS management console for an IAM user account? username and password, because when we say management console, it is the web interface. Which of the following services will help business ensure compliance in AWS? CloudTrail. What is the AWS service that performs automated network assessment of Amazon EC2 interface to check for vulnerabilities? Inspector. This generates a report with the vulnerabilities and scans. How much data can you store in S3? There is a soft limit of 100 terabyte for each AWS account. Storage capability is virtually unlimited. You can store up to 1 petabyte. You can store up to 1 petabyte of data. We'll go with the first one. What is AWS service feature that takes advantage of Amazon CloudFront globally distributed edge location to transfer files to S3 with higher upload speeds? S3 transfer acceleration. Look, the name S3 also matches here in this option. WAF is a web application firewall. Snowball is a physical device to upload. And Snowmobile is a big truck or data center secure truck. Your company is designing a new application that will store and retrieve photos and videos. Which of the following service should you recommend as the underlying storage mechanism? I would go with S3 because photos and videos are object and S3 is object storage. Which of the following AWS security feature is associated with the EC2 instance and functions to filter incoming traffic request? So when you say filter incoming request, and X-ray is also filtering, so let's pick this. And we could always check here a X-ray. So let's see what this does. Analyze and debugs your application. And what we are trying to do here is analyzing the incoming traffic request. It would be doing the tracing. Service map is easier for developers to analyze the behavior of their distributed application by providing request tracking, exception collection, and profiling capabilities. What does VPC flow logs does? So VPC is mainly for VPC. It is not specifically for EC2. So we'll go with X-ray. Which of the below is best practice when building applications on AWS? IAM policy to maintain performance, I don't think. Strengthening physical security by applying the principle of least privilege. Yeah, this is good. Decouple the component of the application so that they run independently. This is also good. Ensure that the application runs on hardware from trusted vendors. So it is saying strengthening physical security. So we are not, this is not a physical security principle of least privilege. So decouple component of application so that they run independently. What is AWS data warehouse service that supports a high level of query performance on large amount of data set? That is Redshift. AWS has created large number of edge location as part of its global infrastructure. Which of the following is not a benefit of using edge location? Edge location are used by CloudFront to distribute traffic across multiple instances to reduce latency. This is true. This is the benefit. Edge location are used by CloudFront to distribute the content to global users with low latency. Edge location are used by CloudFront to improve your end user experience when uploading files. Edge locations are used by CloudFront to cache the most recent response. So I guess it could be uploading the files. No, actually, I want to correct myself. It would be first, because this is the purpose of load balancer, to distribute the traffic across multiple instances. Upload can also happen from CloudFront edges. In your on-premise environment, you can create as many virtual servers as you need from a single template. What can you use to perform the same AWS? It is called as AMI, which is Amazon Machine Image. This is like a ghost image, so you can make several copies. Amazon Glacier is an Amazon S3 storage class that is suitable for storing Dash and Dash. Dynamic website assets, no. Active database, active archives, long-term analytical data, cached data. So Glacier. Long-term analytics data. And active archives. You are working on two projects that require completely different network configuration. Which AWS service or feature will allow you to isolate resource and network configuration? Virtual Private Cloud, VPC. Which is the AWS service that enables you to manage all of your AWS accounts from a single master account? AWS organizations. Which is the AWS service that provides you the highest level of control over the underlying virtual infrastructure? EC2. Because DynamoDB, you cannot SSH to the system. RDS, it would have deployment. It's a shared thing between AWS and you. Redshift is in the similar line, but with EC2, you have the highest level of control. Which AWS service can be used to improve the performance of a global application and reduce latency for its users? Global Application Accelerator and CloudFront. According to the AWS shared responsibility model, which of the following are the responsibility of the customer? Ensuring that underlying EC2 host is properly configured, protecting the confidentiality of data in transit, controlling physical access, managing environment event. So it would be these two. No. It would be patching application installed on EC2, because protecting the confidentiality of data in transit in S3, I don't think if you are able to do that, that is being taken care by AWS. Which of the following EC2 instance purchasing options support the bring your own license model for almost every BYOL scenario? Dedicated hosts or dedicated instances. These two look similar, but I guess it would be dedicated hosts. Which of the following procedures will help reduce your Amazon S3 cost? It would be use the right combination of storage classes based on different use cases. What is the AWS tool that enables you to use scripts to manage all AWS services and resources? CLIs, command line interface. A company has business critical workload hosted on AWS and they are unwilling to accept any downtime. Which of the following is a recommended best practice to protect their workload in the event of an unexpected natural disaster? It would be deploy AWS resource to another AWS region and implement an active disaster recovery strategy. A company has a large amount of structured data stored in their on-premise data center. They are planning to migrate all the data to AWS. What is the most appropriate AWS database option? So if it is structured data, I guess it would be SQL, which means the relational data. And most appropriate option would be RDS. Otherwise, if it is JSON or NoSQL, it would be DynamoDB. A company need to host a database in AWS, in Amazon RDS for at least 3 years. Which of the following option would be most cost effective? Reserved instances, partial upfront. Because when you do partial payment, you get more discounts. Which of the following should be considered when performing a TCOS, total cost of ownership analysis, to compare the cost of running an application on AWS instead of on-premises? एप्लीकेशन डेवलपमेंट, फिजिकल हार्डवेयर, बिजनेस एनालिसिस, मार्केट रिसर्च। दिस इज कंफ्यूजिंग बिकॉज वी हैव टू फैक्टर इन द एप्लीकेशन डेवलपमेंट कॉस्ट, फिजिकल हार्डवेयर कॉस्ट, Saving plans are available for which of the following AWS compute resource? Choose to. Based on the AWS shared responsibility model, which of the following are the sole responsibility of AWS? Creating hypervisors for sure. Hardware maintenance. Sarah has deployed an application in North California, US West 1. After examining the application traffic, she notices that about 30% of the traffic is coming from Asia. What can she do to reduce the latency for the users? Create a CDN using CloudFront so that content is cached in edge location close to in Asia. This is a good strategy. Migrate application to hosting provider in Asia. Replicate the current resource across multiple availability zone in the same region. Recreate the website content. What are the connectivity options that can be used to build hybrid cloud architecture? Direct connect. And probably VPN, because that would be used for hybrid clouds. Which of the following is equivalent to a username and password and is used to authenticate your programmatic access to AWS services? Access keys. What are the advantages of using cloud computing over using traditional data centers? First is distributed infrastructure. Second is eliminating single point of failure. Because on cloud, if one availability zone is down, you will get another region as a failover. Using Amazon RDS fall under the shared responsibility model. Which of the following are customers' responsibility? Managing the database settings and building the relational database schema. Using Amazon EC2 falls under which of the following cloud computing model? It is PaaS, platform as a service. If they give you Amazon DynamoDB, it is software as a service. Infrastructure as a service is when they give you firewalls or hypervisors. Platform as a service would be your EC2. Like you have a image, Linux image, on which you could do things. So that is a platform as a service. Which AWS service can be used to estimate a dedicated private network connection between AWS and your data center? So dedicated network would be AWS Direct Connect. What are the Amazon RDS features that can be used to improve the availability of your database? Multi-zone deployment. And read replica, because availability means it should be available, HA, higher availability. So if you have more read replicas, performance would be great and availability would be more, which means if one region gets down, you have another replica set for the same. Same holds for multiple AGRA zone or availability zone. What are the AWS services features that can help you maintain a highly available and fault tolerant architecture in AWS? Elastic load balancers and auto scaling. Which of the following services can help protect your web application from SQL injection and other vulnerabilities in your application code? WAF, wireless application firewall, would make sure that the rules are configured in such a way that SQL injection and other vulnerabilities in the application code are being taken care. Still, I'm not sure, so I have marked it for review. What does Amazon Elastic Cache provide? In-memory caching of read-heavy application, a domain name system in the cloud, an online software store that allows customers to launch pre-configured software with just few clicks, an EH cached compatible in-memory data store. Which of the following are important design principles you should adopt when designing system on AWS? Automate whenever possible. Always use global service in your architecture rather than regional service. Always choose to pay as you go. Remove single point of failures. Treat servers as fixed resources. What is the primary storage service used by Amazon RDS database instance? EBS. A company is developing a new application using a microservice framework. The new application is having performance and latency issue. Which AWS service should be used to troubleshoot these issues? Not really sure, but we can go with X-ray because that is what is meant for debugging. See, distributed application, tracking, exception, profiling. So profiling is mainly finding out the response time. Your application has recently experienced significant global growth and international users are complaining of high latency. What is the AWS characteristic that can help improve your international user experience? high availability, which means no global reach. I'm not sure. Application has gone global, so, and international users are complaining for high latency. So what is AWS characteristic? Global reach would be a good answer. A company has deployed a new web application on multiple Amazon EC2 instances. Which of the following should they use to ensure that the incoming HTTP traffic is distributed evenly across the instances? That is, since the traffic is HTTP or HTTPS and it is a web application, so application load balancer makes more sense here. What does Amazon Elastic Beanstalk provide? This is a PaaS solution to automate application deployments. Which of the following AWS services is designed with native multi-availability zone fault tolerance in mind? DynamoDB and S3. So we have finished this exam in how many minutes? We have got 90 minutes and we have used 45 minutes, which is almost half the time. We completed 65 questions. So I have marked some of them. Let's see, we'll pass or not. You guys leave the comment if we are going to pass or no. I believe we would at least score more than 70%. Even though there were so many answers which sound similar, but I have confidence we will pass. Let's see, fingers are crossed. 3, 2, 1. Yay, we got 93. That is amazing. So let's see what was wrong. So we were 14% wrong in AWS compute. Some wrongs in identity and compliance, some in networking. Oops, cloud computing models, 100% wrong. It was just one question and rest everything is correct. So we can improve where we were wrong. Let's see. So first answer itself was wrong. See, which of the following impact the price paid for EC2 instance? Instance type, load balancing. Let's see how that matters. EC2 pricing varies depending on many variables. The buying option, selected instance type, select region, number of instances. I'm not sure how load balancing would affect the cost. Allocated Elastic IP address. The number of hours the Elastic load balancer runs and the amount of data it processes contribute to EC2 monthly cost. So if my load balancer is running 10 EC2 versus 2, the cost would be higher, I guess. That is where, and then load balancer technically is free. They don't charge anything for that, but that cost is added in the EC2 cost. That's what I guess. The availability zone where the instance is provisioned is incorrect. The prices of EC2 instance may vary depending on the region where the instance are provisioned, but not on on the availability zone. There is no charge for private IPs. For Elastic IPs, there is a charge. You can have only one Elastic IP associated with it. Number of buckets is incorrect. Okay, now we will go to our next incorrect answer. See, this we have marked for review, and this is built for fault tolerance. So we are reviewing the questions which we picked and also the incorrect answers. So company, when you get the consulting, there is called as Amazon Partner Network, which is APN Consulting Partners. And you can also read about the other one. So APN Consulting Partner are professional services firms that help customer design, architect, build, migrate, and manage their workloads and applications on AWS. Consulting partner includes system integrators, strategic consultants, agencies, managed service provider, value-added resellers. AWS support the APN consulting partners by providing a wide range of resources and training to support their customers. The other options are incorrect. Technology partner provides software solution that are either hosted on or integrated with the AWS platform. APN technology partner include independent software vendors, development tools, management and security vendors for SaaS and PaaS. AWS professional service is collection of offering to help achieve specific outcome related to enterprise cloud adoption. AWS professional services also trains your team with specialized skills and provides global specialty practice to support your effort in focused area of enterprise cloud computing. AWS TAM is incorrect because it is technical account manager, which is designated for the enterprise support. Which of the change management tools that helps AWS customer to audit and monitor all resource changes in AWS environment? So we picked correct answers. Change manager is defined as the process responsible for controlling the life cycle of all changes. The primary objective of change management is to enable beneficial changes to be made with minimum disruption to IT services. Despite all the investment in software and hardware and inadvertent configuration or misstep in a process, can frequently undo these efforts and lead to failure. AWS Config and AWS CloudTrail are change management tools that help AWS customer audit and monitor all resource and configure changes in their AWS environment. Customers can use AWS Config to answer, what did my AWS resource look like at a point in time? Customer can use AWS CloudTrail to answer, who made an API call to modify this resource? For example, a customer can use the AWS management console for the AWS config to detect that the security group production DB was incorrectly configured in the past. Using the integration AWS CloudTrail information, you can pinpoint which user misconfigured the production DB security group. In brief, AWS config provide information about the changes made to a resource, and AWS CloudTrail provides information about who made those changes. These capability enable customer to discover any misconfiguration, fix them, and protect their workload with failures. So Amazon Comprehend is a natural language processing NLP service that uses machine learning to find meaning and insights in text. Customer can use Amazon Comprehend to identify the language of the text, extract key phrases, places, people, brands, or events, understand sentiment about product or service, and identify the main topic from the library of document. The source of this text could be web page, social media feed, email or articles. Amazon Comprehend is fully managed, so there are no servers to provision and no machine learning models to build, deploy, train. NLP is an artificial intelligence technology that helps computer identify, understand, and manipulate human language. AWS is responsible for physical and environmental controls. Customers inherit these. As mentioned, it's a shared responsibility model. Which of the following AWS offering is MySQL compatible? Aurora. An organization needs to analyze and process large amount of data. So Amazon Elastic MapReduce help you analyze and process vast amount of data by distributing the computational workload across a cluster of virtual servers running in the AWS cloud. The cluster is managed using an open source framework called Hadoop. Amazon EMR lets you focus on crunching on analyzing your data without having to worry about time consuming setup management, tuning of Hadoop cluster, or to compute capacity they rely on. Malicious actors sometimes use distributed denial of service attack to flood networks. When dealing with DDoS, it's important to minimize the opportunity of attackers to target application. This means restricting the traffic that they can reach. Configuring security group and ACL would help filter the traffic. The service integrate with AWS Shield and manage DDoS protection service that allow always on detection and automatic inline mitigation to safeguard the web application running AWS. How are AWS customers built for Linux machines? Yeah, we were correct. It is 1 second increment, minimum for 1 minute. So this is storage capacity is virtual unlimited in S3. So you can upload any volume of data. Oops. Which of the following AWS security feature is associated with EC2 instance and function to filter incoming request? Oops. So EC2 instance and filtering the request. That would be security groups. Which of the below is best practice when building application on AWS? Decouple the components. AWS has created large number of edge location as part of global infrastructure. Which of the following is not a benefit? So apparently you can also use CloudFront to upload. With CloudFront, your user can also benefit from accelerated content upload. As the data arrives at edge location, data is routed to AWS storage services over an optimized network path. AWS service that is used to distribute load is the AWS Elastic Load Balancer. Standard retrieval is 3 to 5 hours and work well for less time sensitive need like backup data, media editing, long-term analysis. Bulk retrievals are the lowest cost retrievals returning large amount data within 5 to 12 hours. Protecting the confidentiality of data in transit, ensuring that underlying EC2 host is properly configured. Data protection refers to the protecting data while in transit as it travels to and from Amazon S3 and at rest. While it is stored on disk in AWS data center, the AWS customer is responsible for protecting their data either at rest or in transit for all services, including S3. Patch management is a shared responsibility. Okay, I did not know this. So I thought that EBS would encrypt, but for S3, I guess we as a customer have to encrypt it. You have a variety of options for using existing Microsoft license on AWS cloud. By purchasing regional database service license included instance, you get new fully compliant Windows SQL license from AWS. The bring your own license model enables AWS customer to use their existing server bound software licenses. Your existing license may be used on AWS dedicated host, dedicated EC2 dedicated instances or EC2 instances with default tendency using Microsoft license mobility through software assurance. Dedicated host provide additional control over your instance and visibility into host level resource and tooling that allow you to manage software that consumes license on a per core or per socket basis, such as Windows Server SQL. That is why bring your own license scenarios are supported through the use of dedicated host, while only certain scenarios are supported by dedicated instances. Thank you. Now this we have marked it for review. Question 45, which of the following should be considered when performing TCO, physical hardware? Weighing the financial consideration of owning and operating a data center facility versus employing a cloud infrastructure required detailed analysis. Oops. Using Amazon EC2 falls under which of the following cloud computing models? So EC2 is infrastructure as a service. Let's read about it. IaaS contains the basic building block of cloud computing and typically provide access to networking feature, compute, and data storage space. Infrastructure as service provides you with the highest level of flexibility and management control over your IT resource and is most similar to the existing IT resource that many IT departments and developers are familiar with today. For example, a service such as Amazon Elastic Compute is categorized as infrastructure as a service and require the customer to perform all of the configuration and management tasks. Customers that deploy an Amazon EC2 instance are responsible for management of the guest operating system, including updates and security patches. Any application software or utility installed by the customer on the instances and the configuration of AWS provided firewall called a security group on each instance. The other options are incorrect. So one more thing is read heavy application. This was the question of Elastic Cache provide. Elastic Cache is a web service that makes it easy to set up, manage, and scale a distributed in-memory data store or cache environment in the cloud. It provides high performance, scalability, and cost-effective caching solution while removing the complexity associated with deploying and managing a distributed cache environment. The in-memory caching provided by Elastic Cache can be used to significantly improve latency and throughput for many read-heavy applications such as social networking, gaming, media, or compute-intensive workload. In-memory caching improves the application performance by storing critical piece of data in-memory for low latency access. Cached information may include the result of common database queries or the result of computationally intensive calculation. Additional information, the primary purpose of an in-memory data store is to provide ultra-fast millisecond latency and inexpensive access to copy of data. Querying a database is always more expensive than caching it. What is the primary storage for RDS? DB instances for Amazon RDS, for MySQL, MariaDB, volumes are Elastic Block Store, volume for database and log storage. EBS volumes are performant for your most demanding workload, including mission critical applications such as SAP Oracle, with the performance need, whether you are supporting million of gaming customer or billion of e-commerce transaction. A broad range of workloads such as relational database, including Amazon RDS, and non-relational database, including Cassandra, enterprise application, containerized application, big data, file system, and media. Okay. A company is developing a new application using a microservice framework. The new application is having performance and latency issue. Which AWS service should be used to troubleshoot these issues? This we already discussed before. This is X-ray, because X-ray will understand the application and its underlying service and performing. So you can identify and troubleshoot the root cause of performance issues and errors. X-ray provides an end-to-end view of the request as they travel through your application and show a map of your application's underlying component. You can use X-ray to analyze both application in development and in production, for simple tier application to complex microservices applications as well. And this is the end of our course. I hope you like this. Please leave a comment if this was helpful, and all the best for your exam if you're trying to prepare. My name is Prem Aseem Chen. Thanks for watching. Bye.